Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. The very delayed Starlink 17 mission was even more delayed over the past few days with the last attempt scrubbed. On Sunday or Monday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX tweeted auto abort at T-minus 1 minute 24 ahead of tonight's Falcon 9 launch of Starlink. Next launch opportunity is tomorrow, March 1st at 8:15pm EST. Later into the day on Monday, SpaceX also tweeted due to poor weather conditions in the recovery area and to allow additional time for pre-launch checks, now targeting Tuesday, March 2nd at 7:53pm EST for the launch of Starlink from LC-39A. Yesterday, they also posted now targeting no earlier than Thursday, March 4th for the launch of Starlink due to a range conflict and unfavorable launch and recovery weather. So, looking at the SpaceX fans website, you can see that Starlink 17 is now scheduled to lift off tomorrow at 8:24am UTC or 3:24am EDT. SpaceX also tweeted a couple of Starlink-related tweets on Monday. The first says, at a time when more people are working from home and more students are participating in virtual learning, internet connectivity is more important than ever. With Starlink, we are able to deploy quickly to areas that need it most. Then they posted another saying, last month, Starlinks were deployed to the Wise County Public School District in rural Virginia, where approximately 40% of students and teachers did not have internet access at home, helping to broaden connectivity in the area. There was a NASA briefing about the Crew 2 mission and Jeff Faust posted some tweets about the event. His first says, NASA's Steve Stitch says Crew 2 is still no earlier than April 20th but may adjust date to optimize orbital mechanics. Still looking to fly between Soyuz missions in early April and beta cutout in May. There were another couple of tweets which said, SpaceX's Benji Reed says the Crew 1 vehicle relocation from one docking port to another as soon as the end of this month. And Reed adds that the refurb of the Demo 2 Crew Dragon for Crew 2 is going well. Same for the Falcon 9 booster that will be reflown on the launch. There was yet another tweet relating to Crew Dragon that will fly Crew 2. Jeff Faust tweeted, Reed replaced some valves thermal propulsion system elements on Crew Dragon capsule after Demo 2 in prep for Crew 2. Otherwise, it's really the same vehicle that's been carefully inspected and prepared for reflight. There was also another tweet relating to capsule reusability which said, Stitch, don't see a higher risk with reused Crew Dragon vehicles because we go for a methodical process of reviews. There was also some information given in the briefing relating to the issue that caused the Falcon 9 landing failure recently. Jeff Faust tweeted, Reed says the failed Falcon 9 booster landing was caused by an engine shutdown. Hot gas got through the cover or boot on the engine that caused the shutdown. Engine out capability allowed the vehicle to complete primary mission but didn't have enough thrust for landing. Also, he posted, Reed noted that the cover was a life leader in the fleet, having flown more times than any other. There was an interesting tweet posted by Stephen Clark relating to the reusability of Merlin engines. He said, I count 1,079 Merlin engine flights to date in the Falcon 9 era with three early shutdowns in flight. On all three occasions, the rocket completed its primary mission. That puts the Merlin engine success rate above 99.7% in the Falcon 9 era. Moving on to the stuff in Boca Chica, the orbital launch site work is continuing. SpaceX are doing some work just in front of their wall at the launch site. The new orbital launch pad structure being worked on in the yard is also continuing. Here's that new high bay elevator we saw put up recently in action. There's a new CNBC article which says that SpaceX is planning to construct a new facility in Austin, Texas. They will apparently construct Starlink equipment with SpaceX saying to keep up with global demand, SpaceX is breaking ground on a new state-of-the-art manufacturing facility in Austin, Texas. Musk posted a tweet saying, creating the city of Starbase, Texas. Scott Manley responded with, I hear Boca Chica Village was once known as Copernic Shores after Copernicus. And Musk confirmed by saying, indeed it was. Michael Baylor posted a tweet, the Boca Chica Village area, part of Cameron County, will be incorporated as Starbase, Texas. Musk responded with, an area much larger than Boca Chica. Raptor Engine SN47 was seen delivered to the yard recently. Mary tweeted about this Raptor SN47 as it had a message which said, "When hop, much wow." There's another new body flap that was delivered. An interesting unknown dome was seen being moved. This new ring section was spotted being worked on in a tent. Just to throw in some more Starship news, Yusaku Maezawa made an announcement on Tuesday. He said he will be inviting 8 people to join him on the Dear Moon mission, which will consist of about 10 to 12 people in total. The final remains of SN5 were recently moved to the scrapyard. On Sunday, the flight termination system was installed onto SN10 in preparation for a maiden flight. Everything looked to be in place for a flight on Monday until Mary posted a tweet to the contrary. She said, "I have just received an update that Starship SN10 will not fly until Wednesday, March 3rd. Tomorrow's attempt has been cancelled. No hop tomorrow." SpaceX had attempted to launch SN10 earlier today when there was an abort. Musk tweeted a little later, "Launch abort on slightly conservative high thrust limit. Increasing thrust limit and recycling propellant for another flight attempt today." Then, after a couple of hours, SpaceX launched their third full-size prototype, Starship SN10.
"One, ignition. We have liftoff." "FC2, please prepare for section 35. OSC, FC1, LVN.
T-plus 30 seconds, Starship 10 has lift off. It's headed to 10 kilometers on its test flight from Boca Chica in Cameron County, Texas. Coming up on T-plus 2 minutes, we're getting ready to transition from 3 engines to 2 engines firing on Starship. We'll be shutting one engine off. That's intentional. T-plus 3 minutes and counting. Starship coming up on 8 kilometers altitude. We're getting ready to shut down the second engine. This is intentional. I'm clear. Oh, very nice, very nice. Okay, now to switch over to the header tank for the one engine. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to come back up when we hit 10 kilometers, right about in 3 seconds. Coming up on T plus 4 minutes, we're at 10 kilometers. We've gone into the hover. We're still being powered by the single Raptor engine. T plus 4 minutes and 40 seconds. Starship has transitioned. It's flipped to the horizontal mode, beginning the descent back to the landing zone. Coming up on 5 minutes 45 seconds, we're down below 2 kilometers. We're preparing to light 3 Raptor engines to begin the flip sequence. It'll culminate with landing on the landing pad in Boca Chica.
Whilst editing this video, after SN10 managed to land successfully, she also decided it wasn't over and exploded. Nonetheless, SN10 did incredibly well. Congrats to SpaceX. As always, thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who is out there all day, every day filming this awesome stuff in Boca Chica. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other content. I also want to say thank you to each and every person who has subscribed to this channel. This is my 100th Starship Updates video and it's been a long road, but this is just the beginning. I can't thank you all enough for the incredible support. Just a reminder, we have a shop with some cool SpaceX themed stickers if you are interested, there's a link in the description. Also, we have a Discord server where you can come and join a bunch of space fans, there's a link to that in the description too. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.